Hi, welcome to the second video of my new segment, which I've recently started, and that is Success Stories. So in this segment, what I do is I talk to successful entrepreneurs who have gone that extra mile and taken extra efforts to ensure that they get good enrollments. So today in this particular video, I have Mr. Somnath with me, who owns two EuroKid franchisee centers in Bangalore. He has successfully, even in this pandemic situation, he along with his wife, Pushpa ma'am, has successfully enrolled 60 admissions as of now for the next academic batch. These are the confirmed admissions for the next academic batch. So I have been associated with Mr. Somnath since 1.5 years now. So let's hear it from Mr. Somnath. Hi, Somnath. Good evening.
Hi, Sanket. Very good evening.
Yeah, so as you know, we are doing this section. And to start with, before we get into the actual marketing strategy and all those details, if you can just help my viewers by giving a brief background of how you got into this preschool industry and background about yourself and Pushpa ma'am. So over to you.
Sure, Sanket. Thank you very much for giving this opportunity to come on your new forum. And first of all, a big congratulations to you on this endeavor. My name is Somnath Havargi, and my wife is Pushpa Havargi. We have been working together since very long time, almost 2.5 decades now. So originally we both are IT professionals. I'm a very hardcore computer technologist by education background. I'm an engineer in computer science. And I was privileged to work in very prestigious and big projects in India as well as in the United States. We worked together in the US also. I have done some very memorable projects. In India, you know, the biggest pride that I have is IRCTC.co.in is my baby. I was the architect in the very beginning, the initial stages. Anyway, now what I'm saying is I come from hardcore technology background. Same with Pushpa also, she was an IT professional. Okay. And we started our first school, that is our Rupudinagar branch, around 11 years ago. Now, that time Pushpa wanted to again come back to the mainstream and do some business, and we thought, like most of the women who want to come back to the mainstream do, right? We thought about a preschool, and in addition we had our bungalow. My residence was free that time, it was empty. Then we thought, why shouldn't we try out? Then we did some good research, and we found that EuroKids was doing very good, and it has very nice curriculum and things like that. Anyway, we were very satisfied, and we started with our first branch in 2010. You know, I need to tell you, the kind of place we lived in was very tough area. It is surrounded by industrial estate, you know, and most of the people who stay there are not really upper classes, very middle, lower middle class to very low class. Okay, so we had to depend upon the people far away from my location. So it was a very tough time, though we started with just 13 kids in the very first year. Before the pandemic year, we were able to cross 300 students in our Rupudinagar branch, and more than 200 in our second Jalali Cross branch. That area was very tough, and even today we face that, because you know, for the getting staff is very difficult. They prefer to go to, you know, IAS, the maids, they prefer to go to a garment factory in the vicinity than coming to us, because they can make more money there. In spite of this situation, you know, we were able to put forward our all experience, whether it is IT experience or something else. You know, just coming back to my background, besides IT, I have been doing so many other things, and education is one of them. But education industry has been very fruitful for us. It has not only given the livelihood, it has given us a good position in the society and some respect and things like that. I think I'm overshooting your question.
No, probably.
I'd like to come back to this. We are doing good. If you know, everybody wishes that this COVID year was not there. Had it not been there, certainly we would have two centers together. Yeah, I was talking about the second center. We started our second center in 2015 in Jalali Cross. That location is, though it is just 2 kilometers away from here, that location is a little different. That's a residential area, whereas this Rukmininagar is, it was like a farm in the beginning when we started, but now density has increased, but not the density that we look forward for. For example, if you go to some areas in Bangalore, you find only apartments and only people. And here it is not like that. We used to find only greenery and the factories around us. Okay, coming back to you.
Yeah, that's great. I mean, from a corporate background, you both have completely shifted and started your entrepreneur journey. So I'm sure initially it must have been really challenging, because when you run your own business, you have to take care of everything, right? From marketing, operations, when it comes to preschool, academics, trainings, a lot many things, right? Sure. Budgeting. So really nice to hear that. So I'll jump on to my second question. This is that question which most of my viewers are really excited about, that you are owning two centers. And as you said, you have already confirmed 60, right? 60 admissions.
Correct.
For both these centers. So around 120 admissions is what you have confirmed for the next academic batch, as in the 2021 June batch. Okay, so can you just throw some light on how you were able to, because see, in the current situation, most of the preschools, the challenges that they are facing are, they are not able to convince the parents about the importance of education, and they are not able to convince them that they should continue, although it's not offline school, the child needs to continue the education through the online mode. How were you able to do that? If you can just tell our viewers about that.
Sure, Sakir. Yeah, before I come to your second question, I would like to continue my previous answer to the previous question, because I forgot to mention a few things. See, because those points are really helping us a lot. Forgot to mention that I am a career counselor. Career navigator. Mm-hmm. Okay, and Pushpa is a well-known child counselor as well as a family counselor. And she has done a couple of diplomas in early childhood education and stuff like that. Even before we started the school, she has done a lot of background work, and she did. She got extra information, extra diplomas and stuff like that. Okay. So what we are saying is we have the right knowledge to start a school, right knowledge to be connected with the people. And again, besides that, we are also doing so many other things. You know, for example, I'm a proud Rotarian. I was a Rotary president in my club previous year. Okay. And as I told you, I'm a career counselor, and we keep meeting a lot of people.
Okay. Right.
And we see, education is one thing, but we are not treating education as a line of pure business. Okay, it is okay. Certainly, we have to make money. Without money, we cannot survive. But certainly, education is not. We are not treating education as the commodity here. You know, we are also trying to be in touch with the people, and we are in touch with people in many, many different ways and angles, and that is really helping us a lot. And when it comes to numbers, see, certainly we are not behind the numbers. Numbers were our least priority. We are doing our job sincerely, with full honesty.
Yeah.
Okay. And we always want to give quality education. We were never behind the numbers, but thanks to this approach, we are having good numbers. Ever since we have started this first school, though I said, you know, we started with just 13 kids in the very first year, the growth was phenomenal. Like, you know, if I remember right, next year it was like 47, 67, 80, 100, 120, like that, the graph went on, and we have been actually awarded for consistent growth also from the EuroKids. Okay.
Okay.
And coming back, how did we do? Yes. You know, as I was telling you, we are never behind the numbers. Quality, honest education is our core.
Right.
And we are not just restricted to those ABCDs or 1, 2, 3s. You know, whenever you talk about the curriculum, syllabus, they just talk about the numbers, ABTC, ABCDs, and some stories and things like that.
Yeah.
We go, I mean, I'm not sure whether I'm supposed to say this officially or not, but we go much beyond the given curriculum. For example, one other thing I forgot to tell you is I am an NLP practitioner for past 8 years.
Wow.
Okay. So I try to use those skills when we are imparting education to our children.
Right.
We conduct something called as brain gym for our children. Okay.
Okay.
Our kids are so good. The kids who are graduating out of my school are so good. They're so communicating. They're so confident that any school they walk into, they are most welcome. Okay. The moment they say, if the parent says, my child is from Eurokids Rukmini Nagar or Eurokids Jhalali Cross, I think they're just taken in, because that is the kind of standard we have established for the children.
Okay, right.
And the word of mouth works in a big way for us, okay, because we have been existing for 11 years in this area. Though I told you the area is very tough, but we have been able to build that relation with the families. There are cases even not only the second child, even the third child in the family has come to our school. So that is the kind word of mouth relation we have. The key is the relation with the neighborhood and the community.
Yeah.
Okay, coming to again numbers, see, as you rightly mentioned, 60 plus 60, 120 is the confirmed numbers. But we are expecting at least 100 plus in the coming few months. See, as you know, the situation in Bangalore is pretty bad, just like in Mumbai. And every day the counts are something like 20,000, 30,000 kind of numbers are coming up in COVID positive graph. Okay, so people are delaying for one or the other reasons.
Right.
There is a lot of uncertainty is there, but they're all saying, sir or ma'am, don't worry, we will be there, we'll come, give us some time, we will be there. So we are sure that we will cross 150 each for the coming year. That is the minimum number we are looking at.
Okay.
And optimistically, we are looking at the previous year number, that is, you know, both centers together, we will be crossing 400 to 500 at the end of this next academic year, that is 21-22. I think so.
Wow.
I hope so.
Yeah, so as you rightly said, sir, I consult a lot of other preschool owners as well. As you rightly said, word of mouth. So the first year of preschool is only when you need to do marketing. Okay, once you have those 40-50 admissions in the first year, then these 40-50 students and parents, they act as your brand ambassadors.
That's critical mass.
Yes, only if you are delivering the quality service. So absolutely right what you said. So great. So moving to my next question, which is one of my favorite questions because it is related to marketing. So my viewers would like to know, was there any specific marketing strategy that you used? So although you said that you don't treat the preschool business as a business because it's very close to your heart, and but still, I mean, there's some kind of marketing strategy which is in place. So if you can just talk about what strategy you used.
Wow, very interesting. See, whatever said and done, for our livelihood, business is required. And for a business to survive, the sales and marketing is very, very essential. There is no second thought about that. Yes, there has been a lot of strategies. And I think, as I told you, we coming from technology background, we have been using various methods of promotions. But the significant one is certainly the online and the digital marketing. Okay.
Okay.
Initially, yes, digital marketing was not there so much in the stage.
Right.
We had to use the typical, very typical of traditional ways of things. We have done everything, that pamphlet distributions, you know, printing pamphlets and inserting into newspapers, putting banners every nook and corner of the area.
Yeah.
And we used to sponsor a lot of events around our area. That used to really help a lot. And we used to do a lot of social service activities. See, this is one key point I would like to highlight again once again when I get the opportunity. We need to connect with the people, correct?
Right.
Whatever it takes, whether it is by pamphlet distribution or something else. We have done a lot of other social service kind of activities also, maybe setting up a health camp or, you know, we conduct health activities in the school also. For example, pulse polio. this pulse polio vaccination happens in both my centers. Okay, because of that, a lot of children in the right age come to my school.
Okay. Yeah, right.
And besides that, we used because of our good connection with the health in, health department. Mm-hmm. You know, we were able to make use of that side of
right.
I wouldn't call it marketing, but that way of marketing.
Correct.
Yeah, and yeah, coming back to the digital marketing, yes, being a heavy technology guy, we have been using digital marketing since very long time. That time it was not called as really digital marketing, yeah, yeah. It was just marketing.
Yeah.
We have been using Facebook heavily ever since Facebook started this, you know, the promotion kind of options, no? When they started giving, we have been using since then. But maybe we are not very proficient, just like you people are. You people have been helping a lot since last year. You people are doing a tremendous job. But yes, ever since Facebook started that option, we have been using that kind of digital marketing. And we have been very active on Facebook. Similarly, we have been using WhatsApp. WhatsApp is limited to our community, you know, the subscribing community, but whereas Facebook provides other opportunities also. The bigger spectrum is available in Facebook, and then came Instagram. We are present on Instagram also, and we are very active on them. And whatever we do a lot of work in school, okay? A lot of quality activities, actions, festivals happen in the school. But most of the people, what mistake they do is they do not highlight it.
Showcase it, correct.
After realizing that, you know, that's a big mistake, we have learned a lot of lessons. And whatever activities we do, we highlight that, okay?
Right.
And bring it up on all the digital platforms. And we ensure that our subscribers, our people know what is happening in the school. That way, one thing is they know what is happening. Second thing, they suddenly become happy that their child is doing some nice things in the school.
Yeah.
And it helps in a big way.
And it also helps you to stay visible in your community, right?
Yes, I mean, very much. Yeah.
If there's a consistently some of the other posts or some pictures or videos going on the social media platforms, you are always visible. Because nowadays, people are always on their smartphone. After this pandemic, after the work from home began, in fact, the smartphone usage has tripled.
Yes.
Okay. In terms of marketing strategy, you would say that, you have already answered the fourth question as well, because my fourth question was specifically towards social media marketing. Yeah. So, what was that? Was there any particular thing which you did on your social media platforms which actually helped you get more eyeballs from the right community?
Yes, certainly. I have not completely answered your next question. I think now I'll take this opportunity. Sanketji, yes, you know, it is not just doing some activities and capturing the photos and putting on the social media. That is not good enough. No, there has to be quality. And I always talk about quality, okay? Our schools speak about quality. And I believe, you know, our content also is of high quality. Whenever you're taking any photo, the quality has to be good. Whenever you're making videos, the quality has to be good. See, my school has been contributing a lot of educational videos to our EuroKids community also. The very reason is we provide quality videos, you know. We need to be very careful that whatever we produce comes with quality, whether it is photos or the videos. And you know, many people, for example, they forgot to use the mic when they're recording the video. They forgot to use the mic. The camera will be far away and they'll be talking at least 5 to 10 feet away, and the voice is not heard or it is blurred. Okay.
Correct.
We need to take care of those small things. Okay. And we have been training our teachers in a very robust way. This is something I need to tell you. Pushpa and myself again come from training background also. We keep conducting the training for not only our children, teachers, we also do workshop for other people.
Okay.
So that's a lot, you know, in upgrading the quality of teachers. You know, you just speak to one of my teachers or talk to them, you can find the difference. They're so polished. They're so nice to talk to. Okay. It's all because they have done good rehearsal. They have gone through our training. internal trainings, external trainings. Let me tell you, they're really highly polished, okay? I need to say that. So this quality is very important. Whatever we do, the quality has to show up. And when the quality is shown on the digital media, electronic media, people can make out, you know, they can see that there is a difference between the content from my school and other schools. Yeah. I'm not saying that other schools are not doing it. Certainly, everybody in this pandemic year have learned a lot of new technologies, techniques, things and stuff like that. Yeah. And there are so many other schools left out also. There has to be some balance. But surely, my staff is on the better side, and they are doing a great job. And thanks to that, I think certainly our numbers will grow.
Definitely, sir. So, I would, request all the viewers to just go and check their both Facebook pages as well as Insta, and maybe you can just give them a thumbs up and like their page. But yes, as Somnath ji rightly said, that these social media platforms are freely available for all of us. So why not use them in the right way? And as he rightly said, yes, using them does not mean just uploading any number of pictures. But yeah, the content that goes on these social media platforms, may it be YouTube, video or pictures, anything, that has to be quality content. Even the captions, even the hashtags that you put. So we have to make sure that, because all these things combined together, they give you a very professional look and feel to your social media platforms. And
just want to add here, sorry for the interruption. I'm telling the audience, viewers here, if you're not very familiar with social media and the quality content, kindly make use of some professionals. For example, Sanket ji is sitting here. Try to make use of services from such people and ensure that whatever you are putting up on your social media, you know, is having high quality and it is quality content. So kindly go for that. Okay, please go on.
Yeah, thank you so much for that. Yeah, so just to throw some light on that, we are a team of around 12 people who are specifically handling social media platforms only for preschools, and the whole team, right from the designers, the developers, content writers, social media managers, all these people in my team are experts in the preschool domain. So every month we come up with a complete different social media marketing strategy for the schools. Accordingly, the content is written, the designs are made, and they are scheduled on these their respective pages. Okay, so yeah, that's what we do. And thank you, Somnath ji, for letting people know about the good work that we are doing for your school. My last question to you is, in the current situation, okay, wherein all these schools, the school owners, the teachers are going through a tough time, and they are facing so many challenges, okay, what is that one advice which you would like to give to all the viewers or all the preschool owners who are currently watching this video?
Sanket ji, again, thanks for this opportunity. See, I'm not really that big guy to give advices to other people, but certainly, surely, I can share my little bit of experience.
Yeah.
As I was telling you, you know, that honest and sincere work certainly helps. When people look into your eyes and they can see the honesty in you, certainly they will trust you. There is a general belief in the society that these educationists have become, you know, they're using so many bad words for us, okay? You know, they think that we are behind money and we are just behind money, nothing else. Mm-hmm. But I don't think any of our parents will say that, because they know us. They know us personally. They know how sincerely and how honestly we are working. So please have this, have that honest and sincerity in whatever work you do. Let the parents, the neighborhood, see your honesty. Okay.
Yeah.
Then certainly they will trust you. They will come back to you. They know that you are not the one who is going to cheat them. Okay. That's one thing. Second thing is, yes, we are all going through very tough time. You know, I don't know how we have survived 1 year, and how long it is going to last, for how many more months. There are big uncertainties.
Right.
But whoever lasts this next some more months or maybe this half year,
around six,
and certainly survive in a big way, and they will thrive in a big way. The success is there for them. So little bit of patience is required. Do everything to be afloat, you know, to survive for a few more months, and certainly success is there for you. Don't lose the heart. Please keep up doing the good job, and the universe will take care of you.
Very true, very true. And again, one more thing I would like to tell here is that whatever the situation is, it's a temporary situation. So it's not the end of the preschool industry, and it's not the end of kindergarten education. So hold on to your seats, and just try to survive in this particular period with whatever ways or mediums you have. 6 months down the line, or maybe 1 year down the line, once this pandemic goes off, you are definitely going to rule this industry.
Absolutely.
Okay. So thank you very much, Somnath ji, for taking out this time. And before we end this video, I would like to tell all my viewers to subscribe to my channel and give a thumbs up to this video. If you have any questions or queries related to the preschool industry, and if you feel that there is something which you want to ask me or Mr. Somnath, you can definitely put them in the comment section below, and we both will try to get back to you. Okay. So yes, thank you so much, and thank you, Somnath, once again.
Take care, all of you. Have a good night.